Glad you're still with us. Now, let me draw your attention to what is increasingly becoming an administrative soap opera in Western Uganda. Barara City authorities are locked in a bitter row with the old district administration or team who should occupy the current district headquarters plus other assets that were left behind. By law, Barara City is supposed to occupy the current district headquarters at Kamkuzi Hill while the district moves to Bwezibwera in Kashari County. But as you will see in this report, the tug of war is not just about to end.
1st July 2020 was viewed as a milestone by the current NRM regime for having elevated seven municipalities, including Barara Town, into Barara City status. Local Government Act Section 4 equates a city with a district which necessitates one of the entities to relocate. Barara City has been in full gear to occupy Kakumizi Hill, where the district headquarters currently sits, but this appears to have hit a deadlock after the district authorities expressed unwillingness to move.
The law is very clear. When an administrative unit is created, it goes to a certain place, and the government gives that administrative unit startup capital. Put up buildings and ABCD, but only it goes with movable assets like cars, like carpets, like all those, the what, like all those ones can go. And if they have the capacity also to come and shift the buildings, they can take them if it is possible. If they call buildings movable assets, let them take them away. And we see.
Share the property. The city will take some, and Barara district will remain with some. Like, for example, where we have been getting revenue, local revenue, those ones will remain the property of the district, Barara. There is no way how city will take over the source of local revenue for Barara district. And the policy is already in place governing all the cities in Uganda. It is not secretive that it is going to, Barara has got its own. Masaka has got its own. Kabale has got, no. The policies governing the new cities is in place. And it's not true that the city is going to take over every property of the district. No.
City authorities accuse their counterparts of the district over what they termed as illegitimate ownership of the district property.
To other areas like Churuhura, there were facilities where Mbarara was getting a lot of local revenue. When it was Mbarara. Now, when Churuhura or Wampara were created, now the issue of we are getting money from this source, now what happens? That one, you lose it when you lose the jurisdictional authority.
Are going to share, for example, land. They might take land. They can say, let them take land and vote. And at the same time, we need the city. This city is for all of us.
I had acquired land titles in areas of Churuhura, areas which later became Kazo, which later became Ibanda. Mbarara had titles, and those titles were in the name of Mbarara District, local government. When those areas became independent, higher local governments, the titles were transferred from the original title holder, that is the mother district, into now the names of the new local government.
Barara City, which now comprises of six divisions, had planned to increase the workforce from 600 to over 800 as soon as the city operationalized. That would call for more ample space. Earlier plans suggested that once Barara City occupied current Barara district building, then it would turn into a hospital. But with the Rangos now, all this remains unclear. Story compiled by Halson Kagure for the news in Barara City.